60. Haydn, Symphony number 60. It's going to be great. Good evening. How are you? And now, Symphony number 60 by Joseph Haydn. Thank you very much.
Thank you. small word about the next piece. When the Twin Towers were struck, otherwise known as the 9/11 event, I was studying in New York at the time. Actually, I wasn't studying anymore, but I was living in New York. And that tells you how old I am. No, I was in New York at the time, and of course it was a terrible time. It was a catastrophe, and lots of people lost their homes and lives, etc., etc. But the thing that really struck me in those times was two things. The irony that it took a terrible tragedy for the people of New York and the world to unite as people, as humans. I never saw such brotherly and neighborly help and love from anybody to anybody. And that was very special to see. And anybody that's been to New York knows this quite a negative energy place can be, and people are screaming at each other. It's like, yo, get out of the car! You know, it's this kind of energy. But for weeks, it was just love and help. And so seeing that, witnessing that was definitely something impactful. And what also I thought was remarkable was in this time of darkness, where futures were uncertain, people were still wondering what's going to happen. There was so much light. There were vigils of candles all throughout New York City. And it was so bright and so beautiful. And I remember thinking, wow, there is so much light on this planet if only we let it be. And so I got inspired. I started to see chandeliers of light swirling around Manhattan, giving light to the city and to the people. And so it inspired me to write this next piece called Chandeliers.
Thank you.
1920, his first symphony was premiered, and it was an absolute disaster. The critics hated it. The conductor was drunk during the performance. I mean, everything. Rachmaninoff apparently hid backstage and ate some cheese. It was just really. And he went into a massive depression and didn't compose for many, many years. Until he found a doctor by the name of Nikolai Dahl. He was a psychologist and kind of therapist, and I think through hypnosis, cured Rachmaninoff. How do we know that he cured him? Well, Right after that, he wrote the famous Second Pianoncello, which is one of the most listened to and loved pieces today. And the music bears the dedication à Monsieur Nicolas Dahl. I would now like to play the slow movement from the Second Pianoncello all by myself. Well, of course, with the help of the L'Orchestre National Jeune de Luxembourg.
I never needed anyone. Making love was just for fun. Those days are gone. Living alone, I think of all the friends I've known, but when I dial the telephone, there's no one home. Absolutely no one. Thank you. Nobody loves me.
This is a little song that I wrote. When I was feeling very depressed. Just have to laugh at the happiness that's all around you. You just have to laugh, and the beauty of life will astound you. Go ahead and laugh before misery has finally found you. Let the fun begin, either way you win. Ha, 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 ha. When you're in a rut, look at what you've got. Broken ribs and a cough. When you're in pain, don't you complain. Rather go insane. That's how people laugh in Vienna. Ha 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 ha
never, never have to hide the happiness that is inside. All you have to do is
sitting all the time, please stand up now. We could go on and off, but if you could just imagine that we go on and off. We spend a lot of time, a lot of energy, you know, lights, heating, an energy crisis, so we're good to move it on, and we should sort of think about the environment, and sort of dolphin, and drive Teslas, and drink algae, omega-3, spirulina, spinach, proteins, whey, actually, also, we're very hungry, they're very hungry, they're very excited. We're just moving on, thank you so much. Actually, on a serious note, I would like to say something that, we're living in strange times, let's say, auspicious times, questionable times, and one of the things that is unhealthy and unpleasant about this time, in my opinion, is that we are rapidly losing our connection with culture. And one could say, well, we had this crisis and this and that, but that's no excuse for losing touch with culture, the arts and music, and in particular in supporting and promoting the young musicians and the musicians of the future. I want to thank you all very much from the bottom of my heart for all showing up today and supporting these young people. You have no idea how much they work hard, that they're not getting paid, thank God. No, they're playing for passion, and their evolution and in the last week has just been extraordinary, and most of all, their open-mindedness. And we need open young minds for the future. So please continue to support l'Orchestre National Jeune de Luxembourg. Thank you so much. Thank you.
is give peace a chance.